Hello there and welcome back. As you may remember from my previous video, I have shown you the Asciinema module, and I thought I would create a decent gallery for it where you can upload your recordings and give it a nice title and a description so you can present them to others. It may be useful for just a fun project where you want to collect, let's say, special commands that you like for a reason, or you can use it at your company, if you will. I don't really mind. So, in order to use this, all you need to do is clone this project. And after you have cloned it, all you need to do is create a virtual environment and ASCII gallery is going to be the name of this virtual environment. And after the virtual environment is ready, and I can show you what it looks like, I'm going to walk you through the logic behind this web application. It's kind of simple. There is just a little bit of trick how you can get the static files in the proper order in order to use this gallery. And if you have a requests module in Python, you can upload any kind of gallery. So the virtual environment is ready. Let's activate it and install the Flask module. After we have installed this Flask module, all we need to do is start the asciigallery.py. So Python asciigallery.py. We should allow access to the localhost. And let me pull up a browser. So localhost 8000. And now, as you can see, this is how the gallery looks like. So every upload you make, you are going to push them to this site. And after that, if we start one of the recordings, you can, let's say, see what happened here. So this is a virtual machine in which I have recorded it. And these are just simple commands in Python. There is an import this statement and the for loop. And basically that's it. So this is not about what you present, but how you present it. So basically what you can do here is that you specify, let's see how this works. It's in the Asciinema gallery's repository description on how you can upload a specific one. So let me walk you through how this works. Basically, these are the modules that we are going to use. There is a daytime module, an OS module, and a UID module. The only basic module which you need is the Flask. And that's the only one you need to install if you are on Python 7.0. So we create our application object. We are going to create the casts.json. And this casts.json is going to hold a unique ID for that specific Asciinema recording with the title and the description and the date. And basically that's all. This is a dictionary or JSON structure, if you will. And we are going to check to see if there is a file. If there is no file like this, we are going to create one and use it as a, let's say, cache. I have also created a favicon context root, and this is just going to return this nice Python logo. This is just eye candy, so to speak. So I have this default index context root. It accepts get and post requests. And if we have this get request, all we are going to need to do is return the render template functions output for the index.html and the asciinemas. And these asciinemas are going to take the gas cache variables value. So if you don't have any recording, it is going to be empty. It's simple as that. So after that, this is what we do when we receive a post request. So if there is a post request, we are going to upload that specific file. And basically this is how you can upload that file and write it to the proper directory. So we create this file variable. This is going to come from the request files. We have this title and the description, and this is going to be a file UID because we would like to make sure that if someone wants to record or upload something with a, let's say, same name, but different content, they can also upload it. So we will generate a random UID for that. And we will call the save function, and we will save every cast in the cast folder under the static. And we are also going to update this cast cache, and this is going to partake in the get response. And this is the with statement that is going to save that specific cast that we have uploaded. So let's see how we can upload a specific file. Now, as you can see, let me set the syntax to Python. So we need that recorded cast that we want to upload, and we need to read it in this so-called binary format. With the with statement, we can do it in the read binary option. And this is going to be our file, and we need to specify data that is going to have a title that you can specify here, and a description which you can also specify. So let's say, I don't know, how to restart web services, and then you specify in the description that step one, step two, and so on, and the other users can just copy paste it. And after that, we are going to post on the specific context root our files and our data. And this is kind of all I wanted to show you in this video. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more. Thank you for watching.